All right, had a little bit of a scare today. I'm leaving on my road trip tomorrow. It looks like I'll be leaving around, hopefully by noon tomorrow, depending on how long it takes them to do my shocks in the morning. But I made an appointment to go in and, you know, get my hair done, cover gray, and fix my headbands, which I had grown out quite a bit, and get some waxing done as well. The lady who had time for me today was someone I had never worked with, let work with me before at the shop I go to, and I don't think she's been there very long. She felt very new, and I remember asking her if she, you know, had been doing hair very long, and I know I have more ethnic hair, and that can sometimes be something that you can have trouble finding somebody to do properly for you if you don't live someplace where there is a significant population of women of color. Here in Utah, it's mighty white. And that's not a bad thing, because pretty much everybody here has been very friendly to us, and the church has usually been pretty good with us. A couple of times I've had a bishop who was not very accepting. Even had one refuse to discuss even helping me in any way when I was having a hard time with this in my nose. And I know some of my very old friends that haven't seen me in a very long time probably, you know, don't know how long I've had that now, but it's not new. I've actually had it for quite a while now, more than a decade, possibly. I think I got it in like maybe around 2003, 2004, so around 15 or so years, and it wasn't like this random thought for me to do. It was something I did pray on is for myself. It was a very spiritual decision for me. It wasn't a random thing or something I just woke up and said, I gotta go do that, you know. And then I was very careful about the placement of it because I didn't want it to look awkward. I've seen where someone got a piercing like right about here, right in the center of the nostril, and it just looks awkward to me. It was important to me that it did not look awkward, but that's something else. So I went in, and like I said, the lady that I worked saw today, I didn't know her. She wasn't who I usually see. I usually see either Mabel, who's the shop owner, or Danny. She's a wonderful young lady who's very patient with me when I go in about my hair. I'm not a girly girl, and I don't get to go in very often due to financial constraints. So when I do have the money to go in, it's important that it's done right to me, you know, because I'm coughing up all this money, and it's not something, you know, I'm not somebody who gets to have, you know, a regular hair appointment. You know, I only get to go in, you know, a couple times a year, she seemed very nervous. Like I said, I needed some waxing done too. And normally the waxing is something that I'm used to getting done first and the hair second. But she did my hair first, and she seemed, and I'm not a very in the chair there. I guess I'm not a very talky person. I'm just kind of quiet. And, you know, I'll usually sit there with a magazine because that's usually the only time I actually get to look at a magazine. Those magazines are expensive and there aren't any in my house because I can't afford them. So I'm usually pretty quiet. And so, you know, if you ask me questions, you know, I'll respond and engage you, you know, in return. But no, I'm just kind of quiet, and it's kind of a relaxing thing for me to just kind of sit there and let somebody do their thing and, you know, and get me in order. And, you know, so I just chill. Yeah. I'm just chilling, you know, and, you know, and I know Danny said she would give her my card and explain my headbands to her. I've got one here that goes about like that. And then I've got one back here as well. And again, it's kind of like, you know, and I said, okay, you know, and I said, okay, I just need to fix my headbands and get my gray covered in the other areas. And, you know, not super gray yet or anything. You know, the lady I saw today thought I was like 20 something, which I could have kissed her for because I haven't been 20 something for a long time now. My girl is 20 something. but yeah, so she seemed kind of nervous and I wasn't overly concerned about it at first. Like I said, she just kind of felt new, and I thought, you know, she was somebody who was just kind of new to being a hairdresser and having her own chair and whatnot. And so initially when she got started with the hair, she fills in everything. She does the touch up for everywhere in the brown to cover my gray, including where my headbands are. And I just, okay, maybe she was doing it her own way or whatever. And but no, I had to remind her to go back and fix my headband for me. And you know, and that went okay. It's not perfect, and I found some spots towards the back here that didn't necessarily go so well while I was straightening my hair, but they're in a place where they'll basically be hidden, so I'm not freaked out about it. But I was doing the waxing, and she dropped wax in a couple of spots on my hair. There was a glob here. She didn't get me waxed evenly. I'm sure this doesn't show it very clearly, but my sides of my face aren't even, I'm not even trying to go back and have it fixed right now. I'm going out of town tomorrow. I don't have time for that. And then I don't know how she did it, but she dropped a huge glob right here. It was like the size of a 50-cent piece. And then she couldn't get it out. She couldn't get it out, and she couldn't get it out, and she couldn't get it out. She couldn't get this out. And this one was the tiny one, and she couldn't get this out. And I got scared. I wasn't mad. I wasn't not really the type of person to get really super mad super fast. 'Cause it's not like I've never had short hair before, but I've been growing out my hair for a while now, and I don't want to cut it off if I don't have to. A trim is one thing, but the thought of what I would have to do to get rid of that glob, I was really scared. And she couldn't get it out. She couldn't get it out. And, so I left, and they were not out, and I wasn't sure what to do, but got home, and coconut oil. They didn't have this in the shop. Maybe they should keep this in the shop, especially in a shop that does waxing. I use this quite a lot for different things. It's good, you know, as a conditioner for your hair. It's good for dry skin. And so I almost always have a jar of this in the house now and have for a while. And you can even use it to pull through your teeth to help clean and whiten your teeth. So I had rub this into my hair and in the spots where the wax was that she couldn't get out. And I had that sitting there, and I was just trying to chill and calm, and my daughter was helping me as well, talking to me, which is a big distraction because she's often talking about odd things. But and Mabel called while I had that in my hair, and said she could take a look at it for me if I could run back in real quick. But before I ran back in, I hopped in the shower to wash that out, and I used my own hair cleanser. I don't use regular shampoo on my hair anymore. My daughter's hair is quite different from mine. Her hair is curly, yes, but it is a white people curly, I guess we could say. And she can use regular shampoo on her hair, and it doesn't dry her hair out or anything like that. But my hair is different, and I gotta stay away from anything with sulfates in it. It dries my hair out, and you can see from having been washed a couple of times at the shop, I'm really kind of fluffy and fuzzy, but that'll go away. But then, you know, I washed it out with my hair cleanser, which is As I Am, and it's a coconut conditioning wash. It doesn't lather. There's no harsh sulfates in it or anything like that that'll strip all of your essential oils out of your hair, and was happy and pleased that I was able to get it out of my hair, that I was able to get the wax out. I still, you know, went in and talked to Mabel real quick to let her know I'm not mad or anything like that, and the girl didn't charge me because I was upset, but probably not upset in the way they thought I was, because all I could think was, don't cry, don't cry, don't cry. It's if you have to have your hair cut, it will grow back. You've had it short before, but usually it's been short by choice, for work purposes. Usually, when I was over the road truck driving, having it very, very short was convenient and easy to take care of, you know, because you don't have a lot of access when you're over the road like that to be a girly girl, you know, and I'm just not too girly girl anyways, thank goodness. No fake nails. I can't really keep nails. My job is freight, and they're, you know, if I don't keep them short, they get broke off anyways. So I survived. You know, got a hug from Mabel, and I lived to tell the tale. So if you ever find you have gotten hot wax in your hair that is supposed to be hair removal wax, and it's in a spot that you don't need it, and you don't want to cut it out, the coconut oil, and then a good, I would suggest, a conditioning co-wash. You know, what she was using at the salon there wasn't helping at all. It wasn't putting a dent in it. And some people, you know, she when I had told her about this wash myself, because she has hair more like mine and problems with it being frizzy and whatnot, you know, she asked if it was like Wen. I have tried Wen in the past, and I didn't like it because after a while, it leaves a residue that I don't like. And this does not leave a residue. It leaves your hair nice and clean. And it detangles as it's cleansing and conditioning. You know, it's just massage it in all over and comb it through and, you know, and rinse. And you can use another conditioner after it if you want to. Sometimes I do. I did today, especially because of how many times my hair has been washed today. but it worked. I didn't have to cut off my hair to get rid of the hot wax that was in it. And hopefully tomorrow morning when I take my vehicle in to get the shocks replaced, that goes way smoother than this went today. Have a good one.